Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to protect cells in an Excel worksheet. On my spreadsheet, I created a simple form where I want people to fill in some information. I also created a formula here that will calculate their BMI using that information. We want to lock the cells that contain this formula and all of the labels, but unlock the cells where they can input the information. This will be a two-part process. And if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. First, select only the cells that you want to be unlocked, that is, so that they can be edited. I'm going to create a defined name for these called unlocked. This is not necessary, but I want to show it to you as it may be a good idea if you have a larger, more complex spreadsheet that you'll be working with. With the cell selected, right-click and select Format Cells. Then here we'll go to the Protection tab. I'll lift this a little bit. Notice how this is defaulted to locked. This is because later, when we take the step of protecting the sheet, all cells will be locked for editing unless you specify otherwise before protecting the sheet. Because the cells we have selected are cells that we want to be editable, we need for them to be unlocked. So we'll uncheck locked and click OK. So once you do this, you won't notice anything happen. We can still type in what should be our locked cells. That's because to finish locking our cells, we still need to complete the second part of the process. The next step we need to take is to protect the sheet. This will be in the Review tab under the Changes section. Click on Protect Sheet. Here you can assign a password to access. I'm not. I really only do this if I have to. I'm ashamed to say that I've lost access to several Excel files because I forgot my password. But you do as you like. So then we need to select what actions, if any, to allow users to take on those locked cells. For example, if we were to uncheck Select Locked Cells, users wouldn't even be able to place their cursor on any of the locked cells. If you were to select Format Cells, they wouldn't be able to type anything new in those locked cells, but they can change the formatting in them. I'm going to just leave things like this. So when done, click OK. So now to test this, notice that if I try to delete my formula or type in any of the labels, I get an error message from Excel, but I'm still able to type my information into the input fields and my formula will calculate. So I hope you enjoyed this Microsoft Excel tutorial on how to lock cells in a spreadsheet. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks.